off the hook and you don't really want none, but if you do, come and get some. See, tell your mama and tell your daddy and tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Tell your mama and tell your daddy and tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Come get some if you want some, but you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none. I'm Big Snoop Dogg and I'm the only one.
Hey, everybody, it's the coach. This is the...
Coach, the weather this time of year in the South, perfect. Fall football weather, and we've got the roof wide open here at Mercedes-Benz Stadium in the heart of Georgia. Today, we've got a Week 13 matchup for you here between the Carolina Panthers and the Atlanta Falcons. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Off the play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan. This one complete to Devontae Freeman. Touchdown, Falcons! Devontae Freeman. His third touchdown now on the year as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Wow, first play of the game, CD, 75 yards. These people, they haven't even filed in yet from the tailgate lots.
Everyone talks about starting out fast. Everyone talks about getting explosive-type plays. That was absolutely a thunderbolt. And on the defensive side, he spent all week scheming, all week preparing, and it seems like it goes right out the window.
So here are the Panthers now under head coach Ron Rivera. And they'll be led out by their quarterback, none other than Cam Newton.
And the tendency for most of these guys is to want to match things right away because they have a lot of confidence in their talent, too. They just saw a big strike against their team, and you know they're thinking to themselves, I can get this back right now on one play. Well, if it's there, you take it. But otherwise, just go ahead and calm your team down. Run the offense. Get things going and see how things settle in.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. Calling no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. Throwing on third down, Newton. Cam fighting, he lost the football, it's out.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete.
I don't know why you would do that. It's almost guaranteed points the other way. I mean, I get it if it's a late-game situation, maybe even fourth and inches. But, boy, that's a huge risk to take.
Yeah, now they're set up in prime position going the other way. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. Good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in what you're the reigning defense.
The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. Brian Burns in there for the sack, and that is now 21 for him on the year. Wow, what a season. So the sack pushes him back, and now third and long for Ryan and the Falcons. Ryan. Well, the two men come together, and it's incomplete. Excellent work defensively. Brings up fourth down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. And with that last field goal, that puts him now at 300 made on his career, and that is something to celebrate.
And that puts him in the top 30 all time. So he's really made a mark, and he's got plenty of life left in that leg, that's for sure.
And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. Carolina getting set to take the field. And on that last drive, Went for it on fourth, turned it over. Good job by their defense, though. They held him to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit nowhere to escape, and he goes down. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. To throw is Newton. And the pressure gets to him again. So now Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing third and long. Out of the gun, Newton. And he's going to be taken down. Sacked back at the two. Tack McKinley racking up sack number 12 for him on the year.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
This one complete to Curtis Samuel. And nothing but daylight ahead. Pass the 20. Touchdown, Carolina. Curtis Samuel, 96 yards, as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. Well, Charles, you said it after the fourth down stop. That's almost guaranteed points the other way, and that comes to fruition with a touchdown.
Well, the unnecessary risk did come back to haunt them, didn't it? End up getting those points that I predicted that they were going to give up, because it's guaranteed points if you don't make that play.
A drive there of just four plays, and Carolina scores to cap it off. So just a three-point game now as they send this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So out come the Falcons now. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left. We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team, and that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a two-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs, so they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them.
It's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
And that's complete. It sends. It'll be a pickup of 13, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. This is taken at about the 14. A big kick that time, 52 yards. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. It doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity. In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Throwing again on second down. Newton, he'll rifle this one deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. The shotgun snap for Newton. And that is incomplete. This will probably be the last play of the quarter. They are going to go for it. It's Newton. And this is incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Falcons will take control of the football in great field position. Throwing now, Ryan on first down. Jones has it. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. 10-7 our score after one right here on EA Sports. Now Ryan. And he's got his star receiver. It's Jones for the Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones. His ninth touchdown of the season. And the Falcons push further out in front. Prater for the extra point. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Well, that drive started with not a whole lot of real estate in front of them. In plus territory, excellent field position. Two plays later, Pater. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field positions, earned him 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down, it caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
It's a Panthers first down, 17 yards on the play.
I'm coming after you.
20.
Check 45.
On first down, it's Newton. Nifty footwork at the 45. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. Now Newton. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A gain there of 30 big ones. But one thing's for sure, they're going to have to come up with something at halftime because he is absolutely roasting them right now.
They're going to go through the whole litany of things, changing coverages, you know, what are we going to do, put a man on him. The big thing to me is treat it like a good pitcher treats pitching a game. Change your timing, change your location. So sometimes you're up on him, sometimes you're back. Just change up the looks that he sees and make him just a little bit more hesitant.
So second and inches after that first down completion went just shy of the marker. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Well, that was a unit that understood exactly where the first down marker was, handed it to their guy who could run it, created some space, and he got there.
This is caught, and he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. That'll be a pickup of 10 as they try to recover from this 10-point deficit.
40, 40, 80.
Watch number 12. Now Newton. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. He was looking to get that one to DJ Moore, but it'll be second and goal.
20.
Another shot from the 1 on second and goal. Here's Newton. And that will be caught by Moore. He's got a Panthers touchdown. DJ Moore with touchdown number 20 on the year as they are now just an extra point away from making this a 3-point game. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Tavecchio good on the extra point. And the lead's down to a field goal at 17-14. So just a 3-point game now as they send this one away. This fielded at the 2. And he'll be brought down at the 23. Make it the 24-yard line. Matt Ryan and the Falcon offense set to get going again. And he's been good. Two first-half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence. Does a great deal for your team. Gives them a lead, and they're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first-half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
On second and 15 now. Ryan, nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Brian Burns in there for sack number 22 on the year. And, folks, that's just a half sack shy now of Michael Strahan's record of 22 and a half set in 2001. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Open man here, Sims complete. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 15. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get into that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. Curtis Samuel and the rest of the offense heading back out there now. He's done his part, but so far it's been in a losing effort, so they've got to fix something.
But that doesn't mean changing anything, the way they're throwing the ball around and his catches and production. Keep doing that. They're going to have to fix some things likely on defense to try and slow down their opponents.
But so far he's north of 100 yards receiving. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Now a pass hauled in downfield. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 27 yards there, a first down. Newton now at 200 yards already in this first half, and he's not done yet. First and 10. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. He was trying to go back to Moore there. That'll bring up second down. Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. Throwing again. Newton going back to Moore. This time he's got him complete. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons 14. And he's top five in the league in terms of receiving yardage because of plays like that. What have you seen from him on film that you like so much?
Well, I'll strip away everything else and get to what we call the moment of truth. When the ball's arriving and there's a defender there, he just comes down with the ball. He competes and takes it away. Great hands, great ability to finish the catch.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Newton now to throw. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. He was trying to go back to Moore there. And now it's third down. On third down, Newton, quick slant, caught by Moore. And he'll be brought down with the first down and a late flag here, too. And he may get a few more tacked on for good measure. So give them the yardage on the pass and half the distance to the goal line.
Because they're inside the 30, so now you don't march off the full 15, right? You have half the distance to the goal.
And that will be caught by Moore. He's got a Panthers touchdown. Cam Newton with his third touchdown pass of this first half. And the Panthers have taken the lead. Extra point up and good by Tavecchio. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So that drives seven plays in length. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Inside of a minute left in the half, does the fact that you're down on the scoreboard influence what you do or, I guess, don't do on this final drive?
It certainly does, but what influences me even more is who I've got running my football team out on the field and the weapons around him. Can he make a play? Can he get into someone that we're going to trust to take care of the ball? If that's the case, I might push it a little bit here.
Julio Jones all alone. Touchdown, Falcons. Matt Ryan now three first half touchdown passes. And the Falcons have retaken the lead. These two teams in this first half, it's been fun. Back and forth, back and forth. Well, it's not fun for the defensive coordinators, but offensive coordinators are enjoying it.
Yeah, they're having streaks here, aren't they? Being able to put scores together and really bunch them up, and we have a tight game here. You know, we often talk about having the right shoes for the right turf. Today is track shoes, because that's what we've seen with these offenses.
Yeah, it's been an absolute track meet so far and fun to watch. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. We're down three, under a minute to go. How aggressive are you going to be in this spot?
Not as aggressive as I probably would want to be. Only down three. I mean, it might as well be even going into the half. That's not a deficit that makes me want to push it and potentially make a mistake in this situation and cost myself even more points.
But boy, getting into field goal range and tying it, that's tempting.
Awfully enticing. You almost talked me into it.
Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. So now Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing third and long. Back to throw, Newton. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. Some boos coming down right now from this home crowd after that call.
Yeah, and that was because of the pass interference call, but for a second there, I thought maybe they'd gotten a look at my appearance as Othello in the high school play.
You were Othello?
Not a good one, let me tell you.
Airing it out for Olsen. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. To throw again, Newton. Open man is Samuel, complete. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they'll march off another 15 against your squad.
And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout.
A gain of 16 yards. First down, Carolina.
So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. Tavecchio puts this one through, and that will do it for this first half. So thanks to the late field goal, we are all tied up heading to intermission. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thank you very much. We're starting to get near the home stretch of this NFL season. It's week 13, so let's get an update on what's going on. We'll start up in the Steel City, Heinz Field in Pittsburgh. And it's the Steelers who are out in front. Ben Roethlisberger.
Due to time constraints, we move you forward in today's broadcast to the beginning of the third quarter. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game. We'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You got everything going your way. You've probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
Now here's a pass on first down. It's knocked away and incomplete. It was Ricardo Allen there on the coverage. So, Charles, tie game here. What are your keys as we continue to play this second half?
I know people think it's always trite when you say the same things over and over, but they're tried and true in the game of football. Who's going to block better? Who's going to tackle better?
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. So now Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing third and long. From the gun, here's Newton. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down. Fair to say the secondary play, whichever side you're on, hasn't really been a glowing exhibition so far, but a nice job there to prevent a long completion.
I agree with you, but at some point, someone had to make a play and try and stop this exhibition of almost speed racing that we've been watching, huh?
Yeah, it has been quarterback and receiver dominated. Now on fourth down here, that pass knocked away and incomplete. A surprising move to go for it, and predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the Falcons will take control of the football in great field position. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. That's good for 28 yards. He's brought down right at the 5-yard line. Give him 2 on the play.
When we talk about Luke Kuechly, you can't talk about defense. He quarterbacks that defense, and at times, but
under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10.
Second goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football. Had to eat it and ended up on the ground.
Big play coming up. Here's 3rd and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
And the blitz does come. Caught by Sanu. And here he'll get it down to the 7. A 4-yard pickup, not enough. 4th down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
And the 13-year man puts it through, but now there is a penalty marker on the field, so let's see what this is about. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
They'll look to run with Freeman. And he gets in. Touchdown, Atlanta. Devontae Freeman with his 2nd touchdown of the game, 4th of the year, as his guys are able to regain the lead.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense. Defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. 7 yards there and a 1st down. On 1st down, this is McCaffrey. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
Tough first half for him. Unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Now this one complete to Robert Foster. And they're well past midfield, just 1 yard or 2 shy of the 40. Give him 15 there, and the Panthers have a 1st down. Newton now, 5 straight completions here in this 2nd half, 1st and 10. Now it's Newton, and they've got the hookup. This is Olsen, and brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. It's a Panthers 1st down, 17 yards on the play. Newton on 1st down. That's going to be caught. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. And he's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the two touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him, double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection.
And he is in. Touchdown, Carolina. Christian McCaffrey, his ninth touchdown of the season, as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep to your assignments, let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking, beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. This is taken at the three. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And now let's discuss Julio Jones. He's been his typical solid and reliable self, hasn't he, Charles?
When you have that go-to receiver that you can count on in a situation where you absolutely have to have him, there's nothing better for anybody who's throwing the football. But the best part is the payoff. Two touchdowns already, that's the bottom line when you throw the ball to a guy.
Absolutely. Not over 100 yards right now, but he does have the two touchdown catches. To throw once more on second and 10. Ryan. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. From the gun, it's Ryan. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Brian Burns able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon. Here's Ryan Quigley now. Back now here on EA Sports. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. There's DJ Moore as he and the rest of the offense head back out there. And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it?
Right.
Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well. For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Newton, meanwhile, here connecting with McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. On first and 10, Newton. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football.
Here we go.
23 yards on the play. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. He was trying to go back to Moore there, but it'll be second down. Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10. And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40. So now Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing third and long. Newton to throw. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Finally, a good play there defensively on the deep ball. The secondary has had its struggles this entire game. Offensively, they've had their way with them.
Here we go on fourth. Newton. Open man here is Foster. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Four touchdown passes now for Cam Newton. And they are able to break the tie and move out in front here in this fourth quarter. And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him. Let him do the rest.
You know, he probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his rack, right? RAC.
Run after catch. And he loves that. And he's going to carry that in at contract time.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback. And it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had the punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. Ryan. Over the middle, complete. It's Gray. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. That one, a first down pickup of 8. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's 1st and 10. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. And that's complete. It's Sims. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A very solid gain of 27. Ryan now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's 1st and 10. The pass from Ryan complete to Freeman. Oh, no, he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. He didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, let's just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free.
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Isaiah Oliver with the INT. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. After the interception, here's Ryan. He's got Freeman here. It's complete. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
That first down completion only netted him 3. 2nd and 7. Now Ryan. Complete to Jones. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. A really good pickup of 28 yards. A looming decision to make on the conversion, down 7, but first things first, they need to score as they come up on 1st and goal. They'll run here with Freeman. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that'll make it 2nd and goal. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. And they're knocking on the door. 2nd and goal now in a 1-score game. Back to throw to the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle. Got to totally command it, make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
And now the 3rd down throw incomplete as well. Figuring they're going for it on 4th down. Remember, though, they do have all 3 timeouts, so even if they don't get it, all is not lost.
Yeah, normally in this situation, when you're talking about having to go for it, everything is in this play. But as you noted, with those 3 timeouts, they actually have a little bit of a...
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Trey Boston. Another costly turnover, their 2nd of this second half. And earlier when I asked you your keys to the second half, you said, hey, it may be trite, but I think it's turnovers. That's coming to fruition.
It certainly is, and let's face it, they named the game after it, right? So isn't it the most important thing?
It's football.
Exactly. They named the game for it. Take care of it.
Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down.
You better be afraid of me. You better be afraid of me. 20.
They'll try and pick it up in McCaffrey. And it would appear he's going to be short of a first down as he stopped right around the 29. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Now Newton. Thomas has got it. Complete. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. That one a backbreaker as they wind up converting there on fourth. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you go make a play on the football.
The throw over the middle, taken in. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A gain of 28 yards there and give them a first down. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Throwing here, Newton. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. So he can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player. Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Brandon looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. Newton to throw. And he finds a man. It's Olsen. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons 23. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Now Newton. Gonna throw deep for the end zone. And it's knocked away and incomplete. It was Ricardo Allen there on the coverage. Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Newton. Flush to his right. Going back to Moore. This time he's got him complete.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness. Defense.
Charles, did I just hear that right? They declined the personal foul. 3 yards. They just declined them.
And I have to think that the official is thinking 20. To himself, did I just hear that correctly, that you declined that one? All I can think of is that someone on the field got confused.
And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you got to feel good about your chances.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. They have a little bit of time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation for me, you just go ahead and run out the clock, shake hands, congratulations, and move on. Because now you're not going to make up for what's happened during the game in this last sequence.
We'll see what they do here in this last sequence. Second and 10 now, Ryan. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left. He was looking for Mohamed Sanu there. And it's third down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. One last shot for Ryan. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked up by James Bradberry. But Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
Ain't got time for no debating. It's for the taking. No hesitation. Don't try my patience. I'ma pour out one for the set, boy, till there's nothing left. On a run to the bread until we all got them baguettes. Hear them footsteps coming, cause we coming for the check.
We ain't gon' run, no, we don't hide. I could never switch, not a day in my life. Long as my dogs stay by my side. We die. We ain't gon' run, no, we gon' hide. I can never switch, not a day in my life. You know me, my dog, stay by my side. Yeah, we gon' ride till we die.
Like that. Ooh, ooh, I'm in my new bag, my bag. You ain't get, at my back.
Yeah.
First of the month, I'm a running back.
Ay.
Same day, why I'm a running back.
Yeah.
Friday, payday, running back.
Ay.
Running back, running back, running back.
48 yards, I run it back.
Ay.
I cop a car, I run it back.
Yeah.
Go your then run it back.
Run it back, run it back, run it back.
Hello?
That's the check calling.
Talk it.
Let me click over real quick to let my check talk it.
Talk it,
I
talk
eat
it.
Ooh, Pac-Man, that's the way my neck talking.
Right?
I ain't never coming back the way the stress.
You don't make no clap back when you backpack my bad, but I'm past that. But an ass back, that's cash. When the money fall, I'ma slap that. Clap when the money go, you don't slap. That's facts. If the money low, I'ma grab from man. When it come back, I'ma give back my bad. When the check hit, the direct hit, I'm glad. When the check missed, the direct hit, I'm sad. Like,
who's that knocking at my window?
My window.
They say that it's the money, I'm like tenfold.
Over and out.
That's gonna make you duck like a limbo. She said she not a, she an,
hey.
Why you do that like that?
Like that?
It's a lot of money. Why are you mad like that?
Like that?
Ooh,
ooh.
I'm in my new bag, my bag.
You ain't getting
too bad, my bag.
Yeah.
First of the month, I'm a running back.
Ay.
Same day, why I'm a running back?
Yeah.
Friday, payday, running back.
Ay.
Running back, running back, running back.
48 yards, I run it back.
Ay.
I cop a car, I run it back.
Yeah.
Go your then run it back.
Run it back, run it back, run it back.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. 30,000 in the pocket, no change. Okay. I might pass the ball, but this is no game. Okay. All my girls, they love and hate me the same. Somebody might want it now.